If you're someone who is extremely paranoid when it comes to computer security, or maybe even not, I think you'll be interested in this video because Google has recently launched a new service called the Google Advanced Protection Program, so you can enable the maximum, most security possible for your Google account and almost guarantee that no one is ever going to get access to it that you don't want. And yes, this is awesome for security, but also not for everybody, including me. I think this is even just another level of security above what I would ever need, and the inconvenience it would cause would not really be worth it. But for some people, such as CEOs, journalists, politicians, the risk is that they might be specifically targeted by cyber criminals trying to get access to their account. And those people might literally be spying and waiting for them to get phished or try repeatedly to do it. And in that type of case where you're at a high risk, this is something that might be useful. So how does this protection program work? And unlike the name, it's not like people in black suits follow you around with earpieces and make sure that no one hacks you, but rather it enables safeguards and disables other methods of access so that only you definitely have access. Specifically, it makes you sign up with two physical security keys. An example is this one. It's basically a little $20 thing. You plug it in, and when you go to log in, you tap the button instead of other methods of two-factor authentication, such as typing in an SMS code. And the idea is that with the protection program, you have to use one of these. You can't use codes unlike regular two-factor authentication when you enable it. Now, when you go to sign up, it says that you need to use one USB and one Bluetooth key, but it did let me sign up with two of these, so I guess you don't need it, but you might if you want to use it on mobile, which I'll get to in a bit. The other main feature is that it severely limits what third-party apps can access for your account. Specifically, it doesn't really let them access any emails or your Google Drive information or files on there, so that if you were to accidentally give access to some app that either got hacked itself or was nefarious from the beginning, then they wouldn't be able to get your account at all anyway. And if you already did give access to certain apps, then those would now be revoked from being able to access your emails or your Drive data. And those are only for third-party services. If you do want to use an app, it has to be an official Google app, such as the Gmail app or the Inbox app or even Google Calendar or something like that. And if you're using iOS, they specifically say that you're not going to be able to use any Apple apps to access your Google account. So you can't use Apple Mail to read your email. You can't use the Apple Contacts to sync, apparently, and not even Google or Apple Calendar. You can use Google Calendar. So it seems like it locks down a lot more than just emails and Drive data, but pretty much almost all information on your account. And on top of that, if you want to log into any Google services, whether it's Gmail or Calendar, you have to use Google Chrome. So I guess the reason behind that is obviously Google can better integrate security features. And I believe up until recently, only Google Chrome allowed security keys. I think Firefox might now, but I'm not 100% sure on that. So that might be part of it. And also Google knows, well, we know how our security is on Google Chrome, and they might not trust any other browsers, especially when it comes to bugs. And the final feature has to do with account recovery. So in the event that you somehow do lose both of your security keys, they do have a way you can recover your account, but apparently they have added extra steps that they aren't really specific about, where it'll take a lot longer to recover your account because they have to verify a bunch of information about you, and they say it could take several days. So this is obviously important if someone wants to falsely request access and say they're you, but you just lost your keys. Well, then they want to make sure that that is actually not the case, that someone's trying to hack into you. So clearly this is extremely secure, probably as secure as you can get at the moment, and it does require you to use a physical security key, which is also the most secure form of two-factor authentication right now. But is it too much of a hassle for most people? And I think the answer is yes. It's definitely not for most people. Like I said before, it's people who are at risk of being specifically targeted, high risk, where someone will really be trying to trick you. And in that case, you need to make sure that you can't be phished, which is why that security key is so important. But obviously with that security key comes a lot of inconvenience and means you're not going to be able to use it in some situations, specifically on mobile. Obviously on a computer, you can just plug it into the USB port. I don't know about you, but I've never seen a phone with a full USB port on it. Now, that is where that Bluetooth key would come in. I guess you could connect that and use that instead. Also, some keys made by Yubico, that is, by the way, the company that makes these keys, they do make an NFC-enabled key. So if you're on Android, you can use that. So it just needs to be nearby, you press the button. However, iPhone is very restrictive when it comes to NFC. They will not let you use this type of feature just because it's so locked down. So if you were to have this feature enabled, it really wouldn't work that well on iPhone. I guess you could use it with Bluetooth, but you wouldn't be able to use the most convenient features like the NFC key. And even if you did have kind of a need for this, it would probably best be used on an account where you really only use it for email, because like I said, if you do want to use it with other services, then you really can't. So it would work really well if it was just for email. You don't have to log into any other services, because then you can just use the Gmail or inbox app like normal. You don't really have to worry about anything. It's not going to be taken away. You can use other services with your regular accounts that aren't as secure. So for those of us who aren't being specifically targeted by foreign governments, perhaps, what would be best for us for security as a balance in convenience? And I would say, like I've said many times before, that would be regular two-factor authentication. Enable it on your account, all of your accounts that have it available, especially Google and your bank accounts, for example, because think about it. If someone gets access to your Gmail account, they have access to basically all your other accounts if you use that as your recovery method. So you can use either SMS codes or authentication apps such as Authy or Google Authenticator. And yeah, I suggest using an authenticator app, but SMS is fine too for most people, again, unless you're gonna be specifically targeted. And if you want, you can actually get one of these keys. I'll put a link in the description in Amazon if you wanna check it out. Again, these are $18. You don't have to have the advanced protection to use this. I have it on my account, so you can actually have it so you can use any of the methods you want, phone, SMS, or authenticator app, or this. And this is actually extra convenient, I think, because I just kind of keep one of these plugged into my computer right on my USB hub on my desktop. So whenever I go to log in, I just tap the button. I don't have to fumble through and wait for a code or anything like that. It's actually easier to have this. And then I can also use the codes if I'm out and about and don't have this with me, or don't have, I don't know, cell reception. I can use the authenticator app. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Not much more to it. Maybe a few of you do decide to enable this, who knows? And the rest of you, I highly recommend enable two-factor authentication again if you haven't already. So let me know what you think down in the comments section. If you want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here. If you want to subscribe, I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. And also consider enabling notifications by clicking the bell, or else YouTube, I'm telling you, they're not going to show you the videos at all. It's garbage. So anyway, again, I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys. So thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.